Hey guys, what's up? It's Grimrass here, and welcome to your Monkey Madness Part 2 quest guide for the 2007 servers. For this quest, you will need to have completed Monkey Madness, Enlightened Journey, and also have unlocked the Grand Tree destination from the Balloon Transport System. If you haven't done that, go ahead and Google it. There's 100 guides out there. You will have needed to have completed the Eyes of Glouphrie quest, the Recipe for Disaster Freeing King Awowogei quest, Troll Stronghold, and Watchtower. You will also need level 69 Slayer, 70 Crafting, 60 Hunter, 55 Agility, and 55 Thieving. However, none of these skills are boostable, and it's also recommended to have a higher Agility level. Around 60 or around 70 is preferred. I will be doing this with level 63 Agility. We'll see how it goes. It's also beneficial to have high Combat and Thieving as well. Alright, so as for items, you're going to need a Lemon, you're going to need Grapes, you'll need a Pestle and Mortar, a pickaxe which you can use, you're going to need logs, a monkey speak amulet, you'll need a monkey talisman. Now I don't have one of these, so we're going to do it in the quest. It's very simple, guys. There will be a monkey that we can basically buy it from, who is on the island, and that's where we're going to get that. I'll show you guys that in the quest. It won't hinder time. However, if you do have one, go ahead and bring it. You might as well. We're going to need a ninja monkey greegree, one of either small or medium size. Either will work. We're going to need food. Monkfish or better is recommended. I will be bringing sharks. A light source. I'll be using a bullseye lantern. If you're using a candle that's lit, I might recommend bringing a tinderbox. I'm not sure if it can go out. You're going to need a hammer and a chisel. It's also recommended to bring a one-click teleport. I'll be using an ectophile. Having stamina potions too, prayer potions, and magic logs. Now, having an antidote +++ or some sort of other form of anti-poison is also very recommended. Antidote +++ just being the longest lasting one. Alright, so for the actual start of this quest, we don't need all of these items, so I'm going to go ahead and go in my bank and bank them. And you should take out just a lemon, a grape, a pestle and mortar, one normal log, and a light source. Also, be sure to take a magic log. It's also recommended to bring with you an amulet of glory and either a slayer ring or a ring of dueling. Alright, so to begin this quest, we need to head to the Grand Tree, which is located in the Gnome Stronghold. Then go ahead and talk to the King. Tell him that you will help him look for Glow. That will start the quest. Now let's go ahead and exit out of his little tree here and run south. Once you get off of this little platform, head a little bit east to the first ladder you see on your map and go ahead and climb up it. And all the way to the eastern side of this building. Go ahead and climb up this tree here. And then there'll be a branch. Go ahead and right click on it and hit investigate. You're going to get a handkerchief. Go ahead and click on that and hit investigate. All right, now we're going to go ahead and climb down this tree. Head back down the ladder. And we need to head to Anita's house, who is located just up here. So go ahead and follow where I go. Now, you know it's Anita's house because she is the one located as far northwest as you can go. And then once up here, go ahead and talk to her. Ask if she has any idea where Glow is. Now we need to go ahead and talk to her again. Ask her what's wrong. You might be in trouble, I could help. Alright, now we need to head back to Glow's house, so go ahead and climb down this ladder, and we're going to be running over there. He is once again located just a little bit southeast from the Grand Tree. Once Once here, go ahead and climb up the ladder and then run east in his house again. Climb up the tree. And now this time, click on the branch which is facing north to climb up that. Now, you see this little gnome statue here? Go ahead and investigate that. And go ahead and turn the statue. Now we need to go ahead and investigate the candles. Search the gnome barrels. Search the gnome crates. Investigate the gnome table. Investigate the fire remains. Open the cupboard. And search the cupboard. You should now have a brush, a mysterious note, and a book of spyology. Go ahead and use your pestle and mortar on the lemon. Use the mysterious note on the candles. Use the pestle and mortar on the grapes. And finally, use the juice-coated brush on the mysterious notes. That's going to get you scrawled notes. Go ahead and read them. Then go ahead and close the note. And now we need to go ahead and climb down this tree and head back to the king. Go ahead and talk to the king. It would give you a translation book. Go ahead and read through that whole thing. Then, use the translation book on the note. And go ahead and talk to the king again. Alright, now we need to go back and head to Anita's house, who is located once again just northwest in the gnome stronghold. Go ahead and talk to Anita. And pick the third option, could you translate these notes? So you'll translate them, go ahead and read them, and let's go back and head to the king. Alright, and once you're done speaking with him, we need to go ahead and head a little bit south down towards Glow's house again, but just to the balloon that's a little bit south from it. Alright, and then just go ahead and right click and hit fly on the assistant here and go to Entrenna. Now keep in mind you can't bring any weapons or armor here, however if you brought what I said, you should be good. Alright, so go ahead and talk to this guy, I guess T, not sure how you pronounce that, and talk about Assistant Lee Smith. Ask if he can teach you the route, and just right click on him and fly back to the Grand Tree. But yeah, once you get back to the Grand Tree, we need to now go back and speak to the king. Go ahead and talk to the king. And that will be part one of Monkey Madness part two completed. Alright, so now let's go ahead and climb up this ladder here and just run a little bit west, into the bank here and get ready to get geared up for part two of this quest, which will involve some fighting and our first puzzle. Alright guys, so I've now geared up, so I am going to be bringing some rune armor simply to protect against the monkeys that will be down in one of the mazes that we're doing in this part. However, for the final boss at the end of that maze, I'm bringing a ranged switch, hence why my gear looks like this, just a fire cape, a nezi, my range gear, which will be switched to rune when we're running throughout the thing. I'm bringing a rune kite shield, barrow's gloves, and a ring of life just in case. You don't actually need a melee weapon, I'm simply just going to be bringing a range weapon, so don't bring like a whip or anything, you won't need it, unless of course you are going to be killing the thing with melee, which is possible, however range is recommended. So, potion wise, I'm bringing a ranging potion. If you are going to do combat, bring like a super combat mix, I believe they're called. Also, I'm bringing one antidote ++4. Each dose of this will cure you from poison for like 12 minutes, so one should be good. I'm going to bring 5 prayer potions. I'm bringing a one-click teleport, which is my ectophile. I have a teleport to Apatol, which you can use if you're able to start and do this quest. If you're on Lunars or something, use spellbook swap, and then there is a teleport to Apatol in there, which you won't need a banana for, which will save you one spot. Also bring a light source, preferably a lantern, because if you do have a candle which is lit, you'll need to also bring a tinderbox. Bring a ninja or a ancient gorilla greegree. Also a monkey speak amulet, a knife, and a pickaxe. And bring a monkey talisman if you have one, however I'm going to show you how to get one. Alright, so to begin guys, simply what you need to do is go ahead and teleport to Apatol. And then equip your monkey speak amulet and your greegree, and let's go ahead and climb down the stairs. Now we're actually going to go and get that monkey talisman now, so let's run a little bit, let's change that to north, let's run a little bit west here to that kid that we once spoke to. You remember that one that was in the banana plantation right here? This is who we need to speak to, the monkey child, when his grandmother's not there. So go ahead and speak to him and tell him that you lost the toy that he gave you. And he's going to begin to cry. Simply here, we either need to wait for his mother to do a complete round around and he'll stop crying, or you can simply switch worlds like I will do now. So once you've hopped, or you either wait for his grandmother to go all the way around, so you see her here, you need to wait, or his aunt, you need to wait for her to be up around here where my mouse is on the map, before you can speak to him, otherwise she's going to throw you out, so keep that in mind. But yeah, once you can talk to him, he will give you that greegree that you need, or sorry, the monkey talisman. So she's gone, so I'm going to go ahead and pop into that mode. Ask if you can borrow the toy, say you promise, and you'll get what you need. Alright, go ahead and equip your ninja, monkey greegree now. We need to head just a little bit east here on the island to where that evil guy is. He should be right here in this building. There's some elder guards out front, I'm sure you guys remember it from Monkey Madness Part 2. Alright, awesome. So you see Garak. We need to go ahead and speak to him. Tell him that the king has sent you. Tell him that it's worth a shot. Now we need to go ahead and talk to the elder guard here to get inside. Make sure that your monkey speak amulet is equipped. And go ahead, he'll let us in. And talk to the monkey, which I can't pronounce his name, the one on the throne, and go ahead and say, I am here to discuss military strategies. Say, of course, my king. Alright, so let's go ahead now and run a little bit out. Let's go ahead and talk to the Elder Guard again, and talk to Garkor. Alright, so I actually banked and took out a stamina potion. I left an annotation also before later on in the video for you guys to see, recommending to bring one. So anyways, now we need to head a little bit west on the island up to this little area you see here. So go ahead and go where I go. And I also switched my food up for dark crab, just because I felt like it might be a bit better to use than shark, just in case. Considering that I'm not really max or anything, right? Now, it's also recommended too, by the way, guys, to start trying to conserve your run energy a little bit here at this point, just because we will be entering that little bit of a like maze type deal soon, which is going to require you to have a lot of run energy, basically to get through it quickly and take less damage. And we're also going to need prayer during that portion too. But yeah, so once you get up here, we need to talk to one of the monkey archers. Be careful to talk to one and not click on one that only has the attack option. Go ahead and talk to them. They're going to say something about a path, and now we need to, basically, now we'll see footsteps, and we need to follow these tracks down until we get to a little bit of a trap door. Which is located, there's basically like a little transport thing up here, and it's just right around here. So you see this glider, it's just south from the glider. Here is the, basically you investigate it to go under. So let's go ahead and do that now. All right, and once you get inside, it's gonna take off your greegree and you're gonna be in this area. Okay, so there's a few things to note before you actually do this. Now this is a puzzle or a bit of a maze and your path is going to be different for everybody. It's randomly generated, so in all likeliness your path is not going to be the same as the one that I do on video. However, what you want to do is always try to travel northeast. So if you click on the compass in game, it will always make you face north, your camera angle, and then you just need to head up and to the right. So it would be this way that my character is walking. And now always try to take the obstacles and whatnot that we'll come across in this that face northeast. Now you're going to come across chests when you're doing this that you will need to basically pick or something along that line, and you're going to do that until you get a key, which will be able to open a door later on. Now it is possible to get a path where you don't run into any of these chests, and if that's the case then you won't run into the doors which require the key to get past. However, I have also heard that there's a pick lock option on the doors that you will come across if you have one of the more common paths. So if you don't have a key, you might be able to get through, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm going to be finding the key from a chest, and I will try to show you guys all the different chest room in this guide. Now, if you do click on something and it says find another route, it means that it's the wrong way for your route. It's been randomly generated that way and you need to find another way. Just once again, keep in mind to always try to move northeast. Now, going through this cavern, you want to protect pretty much melee or range all the time. There, it's multi-combat, right? And there's monkeys in here that attack melee and attack range. I'm just going to protect range the whole way through. And it's also possible to fall below. And if you do fall below, there will be ropes. You want to find the rope that is basically closest to you and climb up that rope to be able to get out of there. But if you do fall down into that little cavern below, there's once again monkeys down there that attack melee and range, and it's multi-combat down there. So if you're down there though, I've heard it's recommended to protect melee, and when you're up here in this spot that we're at now, it's recommended to protect from range. And there's also going to be obstacles like falling rocks and webs, hence why we have the knife and the pickaxe. So if you run into one of them, you just click on the one to mine it and you use your knife on the slash, I'm pretty sure. Okay, so we're first going to actually head south, which kind of contradicts everything that I just told you guys, but there's a reason why. So it's where these things actually start at. I'm pretty sure anyways, if you go all the way north, there's monkey bars, which I'm pretty sure you can't use, but you might be able to. I'm not really 100% sure on that, so go ahead and try if all the way down south doesn't work. But anyways, there's two different ways that you can do this. The first one's called the agility method, and the second one is called the tanking method. It's recommended to do the agility method if you are above level 70 agility or 70. However, I'm going to be using the tanking method since I am not, which you can start basically by going all the way down south here. And I'm going to show you guys a map on screen just here in a second, which basically is the map of this whole thing. But go ahead and run all the way down south here. And I'm going to need to rotate my camera. We can see that if you climb down here, this will be the start of the tanking method. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and begin now. So the first thing I'm going to do is turn on Protect from Missiles, make sure I have everything equipped that I want to have equipped here, and go ahead and scale the rocks. Now, there's two obstacles in this first area here. Not sure why my run isn't working. Go ahead and try to slash the web and see if that works. Little book's tough, you can't slice it, maybe another route. So this is not my route, so I'm going to need to head just a little bit south here. As you can see, you take a lot of damage. Alright, so that works, and I'm going to scale these rocks here and go ahead and clear this rock fall. And basically, as you can see, just the idea of this is to always try to head northeast. So I took the most northeast path first, which was not my path, so I had to take this one. And I'm just going to keep on continuing on, trying always to move northeast. Protecting from range definitely seems like the best idea. Just keep in mind too, guys, that if you do ever, oh Jesus Christ, this is a pain, eh? There's these things you need to pass through the slice web. After you slice them, you need to click that. Keep in mind that if you ever do fall, just make sure that you climb up the closest rope, and that will bring you back up to the top here. And those scorpions are poisonous. If you get poisoned, always be watching for that to drink your antidote. I might even recommend having your quick prayer on melee. That way, if you do fall, you will be right back up at the top. So I'm going to go ahead and climb down here. And it looks like those two paths actually lead into this one room, which is cool. And then in here, there should be some chest. So we're going to go ahead and believe it's this room. No, okay, so it's not this room, but heading northeast per usual, we're going to go ahead and try this little path. See what happens. Slash it. Okay, that's not my route because it's too tough. I see. My bad. I wasn't paying attention. Going to go ahead and slash this web. And gonna run up here, northeast. Take a sip of a stamina potion. I got poisoned, gonna drink my antidote. Gonna slash this web here. Almost out of food, which is unsettling. Maybe bruise or something might have even been better. Going to clear this rock here. Keep heading northeast. And into here. So yeah, if you do come across chests following your path, make sure to go ahead and try to open those things. As you can see here, I'm not being attacked by any ranging, so I'm just going to turn on Protect from Melee. Okay, so that's not my route. So I'm actually going to teleport out here because I don't have much HP and I know they can hit 27s. I'm going to come back with Bruise and try that again. Alright, back at where we left off here, I am pretty sure. So I went ahead and got Bruise and that helped out much more. And also knowing the first part of my path definitely does help a lot. So anyways, once you're here, go ahead and scale these rocks. And there's some chests below. Very nice. We need to go ahead and search those chests. Once again, this could be different for you. Go and search it. Nice, I got the key. Now, if it's the case for you that that's not yours, I think there's another chest over there. And also when we run up here, or I will show you anyways, there's another room with chest in it, which is just a little bit, which is you go north here and then it's to the west. So I'll show you that to you guys. Taking a lot of damage here, quite annoying. So many monkeys. Definitely more of a challenge than the first Monkey Madness, that is for sure, considering there's two different types of combat monsters in here at the same time. And keep in mind that, like, if you are on the agility portion, I'm not sure if you can fall on this one at all, but on the agility one, if you fall, there will be ropes that you can climb back up and whatnot, and that's what you would need to do. Also, if you have auto retaliate on this whole time, I feel bad for you. Go ahead and turn that thing off under combat. But yeah, the second room down here with more chests in it, as you can see, there's a chest right in that corner. It's just down there. Go ahead and go down there if you, you know, haven't found your key. Now, we come to this spot right here. The two doors are coming up. Now, these doors are either or, like, it could be either one for you. So just go ahead and climb down here. Run through this room. Door should be coming up quite soon. Hopefully this is my path. It is. Make sure these things can be quite annoying. You need to pass through the webs. Scale the rocks. Oop, shit. Okay, well, there's a dart trap here, but I didn't trigger it. But you can disarm these traps. Keep that in mind. So yeah. Anyways, go ahead, and there's a blade here. Now there's two doors. There's one over here and one this way. I'm gonna try this one first. So I got through. Go ahead and disarm this spring arm here. And we can run around. Jumped it and go ahead and open door. There's also a pick lock option as we suspected. And now where we're at now is safe, so that's kind of awesome. You can take a bit of a break. Or watch at this point in the video and then go ahead and get here and then watch the rest of it. Now if this door didn't work for you, I'll try to zoom out here and see it, but there is another door which is over here, another pathway. I got the right click on it, so if this one didn't open, you just need to go around this way. Pretty much the same thing, it's just to the left when you get in that last room that we were in there. So pretty much everyone is going to end up at this part of the route, either on this door or the door just over to the west. If you got a route that has the doors and of course the chest in it, there is some confusion right now whether there is a route that doesn't have chest and doors in it, but nevertheless, if you do end up in that case, you just continue on, keep on trying to head northeast until you get to the boss. Alright, so I'm going to go down here now, so I'm going to protect from missiles again, drink a couple brews to get my health back up, and let's go ahead and continue on. So, go ahead and slash this, excuse me, and pass through it. It's really annoying, those things, I always double click on them. Go ahead and pass through it, or whatever. Different for everybody. But just go ahead and remember, keep trying to go northeast here. Where I'm at right now, you can't really go north, the only option is to really go west here. But that's fine. Not going to go south there because of course we want to go northeast. So let's see if this is my path. Hopefully it is. It is. Awesome. Cool. And we're up here. A lot of monkey archers. A lot of them. Alright, and oops. Go through here, gonna scale these rocks. Drink our restore, get my prayer back up. Those nasty sliced webs, I tell ya. Really pretty straightforward. This I actually learned in one of the pauses that this whole thing is actually an oval. So you can kind of keep that in mind. Okay, so you see these holes here. Those are basically, it kind of signifies a new point. This section right here that we're at, you're pretty much safe in other than from falling rocks. So you can keep that in mind. That's not what I wanted. So we're pretty much coming up on the boss here now. There's a bit of an agility portion ahead. So keep that in mind. If you fall in this agility portion that is coming up, we're going to put melee on here now. Everyone should end up there, I'm pretty sure, but not 100%. If you end up failing on this agility portion, just keep in mind that basically you want protect from melee on and that you want to climb up the closest rope. Now, the thing about this agility course is that it's random for everybody which one you should go on. And also, even if it is the right path, you still have a chance of falling. So I'm going to try this rickety ledge here, and I fall right away. So I need to look for the closest rope, which appears to be those vine ports. Cool little area down here, I guess. I guess I'll try this pillar next. Actually, I'm gonna turn this off because if I fail, I will just switch really quick, make sure my fire cube is protected. Yes. I can just switch really quick. However, on some of these, like that one, I can't turn it off during. So this path worked for me. Now, okay, so this is kind of interesting what we've just come up to, the dodgy ground. Now, this is actually pretty much going to be very easy because you see right here where it's like kind of flat and kind of blurred out. This is the path that you have to follow and you won't fail. You just need to stay off the dodgy ground and just stay on this flat part. Okay, so yeah, these were two paths and you see this little cavern here. That is exactly what you need to be to go in and fight the boss. So this is the area that we need to be at. So keep that in mind. I'm gonna stop the video here and start again when I'm about to do the boss. All right, so I'm about to do the boss fight. I've gone ahead and put on my range gear. Now this guy in here does all three different types of attack methods. He attacks you with melee, he'll do range, and he'll do magic. So keep that in mind. We're going to do basically like the Ceridoan boss method where we just kind of run away from him, shoot him with an arrow, keep running, shoot him with an arrow, keep running, or a bolt in my case. And then when we do need to cross back over, we'll turn on melee. So basically watch me do this boss fight before you go ahead and jump in and do it yourself. So now, start off, I'm going to drink my range potion here. I'm going to take a sip of the super restore. Drop anything extra. And there's also worth noting, there's some sort of wall around here that you can investigate that will actually basically let you get back here if you die. I'm not really sure where that wall is, but look around. It looks normal until you investigate. I found the investigate wall actually. I was just clicking around and I happened to find it. So it's this wall right here. Oops. And that will let you get back. So here he is, he's gonna attack you right away. Keep that in mind, and basically just you need to keep running away from him and never let him get close because he'll do constant 30s on you. So he's doing magic for some reason. Here he comes, now he starts running. Just keep that in mind, keep running from him, don't let him get close to you because then he'll do melee, and if he does melee, you're in a bad spot. Just like so. So, yep, probably gonna die here. Teleport out. Shouldn't have done that. But yeah, anyways, I'll be back once I am doing him. If you did fail, or if you did leave or whatever and you have to go back to the boss, make sure that you do get the key again. Alright, so I'm about to do my second attempt at this guy. I'm going to do the safe spot, which I will show you. It's in the west of this room. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead and go in there now. Wish me luck, I guess. Hopefully we don't fail. So I believe to do this, all I need to do is drag him over to the western part of the room. Careful, he can hit 33s. So it should be one of these areas over here that we're able to basically... Oh shit, dude, I hate that. we should be able to drag him basically in one of these areas. I'm looking for it. I think it might be this one right here. So we need to lure him into this corner. Right. And then we lure him around like so. Aha. We figured it out. Alright, and then once he's like this, right, you wait for his health bar to be gone, you attack him, and then you move back instantly. And then you wait for his health bar to go away once again, to disappear, you attack him, and then you move back instantly to this spot. So once again, this is in the western area of this room, so keep that in mind. So you go ahead and attack him and hit him again. You wait for his health bar to be vanished over his head. Then you go ahead, you attack him. And you move back to your spot ASAP, just like that. So I will be back, guys, once I have actually killed Kirk here, to show you what to do. So he has 2 HP. Hopefully this blow will kill him. Careful, that's what you need to be very sure that. Just wait a little bit after his HP bar is down, otherwise you can get hit like that. But hopefully we'll get the kill on him here soon. And there we go, now he's dead. Now make sure that you do take the remains and that you do get his paw. You don't want to mess that up. Make sure that you have the paw and then you can go ahead and teleport out of here. Once again, make sure that you have that thing. Don't forget. Go ahead now and just get yourself to a bank so we can go ahead and get the gear necessary for the final part of the chapter 2 in this quest. Alright, so for this next part, we're going to go ahead and need Kirk's paw, which we just got. We need a monkey greegree, any type. I'm going to be using my ninja one. You need your monkey talisman, which we got earlier. I'm bringing some stamina potions. You're going to need some sort of anti-poison, bringing antidote +++. And I have teleport shroom to Apatol and to a bank in Varrock. So first I'm just going to teleport to Apatol here. And as for the gear I'm wearing, I'm just wearing some weight reducing gear. Go ahead and equip your greegree. We need to go to that tunnel which we were in during Monkey Madness Part 1. So, yeah, it's a bit of a pain. But basically just follow where I go. First, we're going to come down towards... there's a little graveyard down here, and that's where we're heading. So go ahead and make your way down there. It's just south on the island. Well, southeast. Here we are. Go ahead and climb up this bamboo ladder. Let's go ahead and cross. And jump off the end of this. Okay, hold on. You can't do it as a monkey. My bad. So go ahead and take this off. And then you can jump off it. Okay, now just go ahead and equip your greegree again. And let's run... Set this to north again. It's just a little bit south at first, and then we run pretty much hard west. There'll be a marking on the map with the little dungeon symbol. That's where we need to be. And go ahead and climb down this bamboo ladder. Now we just need to run north on this path. You guys have done this before in Monkey Madness, so I'm just going to go ahead and fast forward this part. And we are here. Go ahead and talk to Zunok. And first option, talk about your mission. And he will make it automatically. Awesome, we can go ahead and hold that now and you'll be slightly bigger with the two things. Go ahead and put on your Kirk monkey greegree and make sure that's on. And then once you're here, just go ahead and talk to the Elder Guard. Like a GUI. There we go. Let's go ahead and talk to the Elder Guard to get out. And talk to Garakor. And that should be part two of Monkey Madness, part two, completed. Awesome. All right, for this next setup, go ahead and bring a range setup. That's what's recommended because you can safe spot the second guy that you need to kill with range. I know I said that last time, but this time actually bring range. All right, so also for your inventory, you bring the Kirk Greegree, a Ninja Greegree. I'm bringing a couple stamina potions, a couple Saradoma brews, a couple super restores. That's what I'm using for food. Also have a anti-poison on you, a Yanil teleport, and a Trollheim teleport, and around 1000 GP. It's also going to be recommended having a teleport that will get you back to a bank. Alright, so to begin, go ahead and break the Yanil teleport. And then from Yanil, we need to run down to the entrance of Guntuna, whatever that's called. It's the ogre place. Now, once you get down to the entrance, basically you need to go where my mouse is, so just follow me. So you go up this path here, you go around, down, along the outskirts, and then you cross over here. You'll need to pay 20 GP, and then you'll go across this bridge, and this is where we need to get to. So once you get to this part right here, when you try to jump this gap, you're going to need to pay like 20 GP unless you complete it. I think up to a certain point in the achievement diary or something, and you won't need to. But either way, I need to. So it's good to have that coins on you in case. And then talk to the guy with the, it's the key here. If he is, there we go, he's under him. Tell him that you say, I know about your deal with the monkeys. Tell him that you offer to spare his life. And tell him that you accept the challenge. Put on protect from melee. You can pretty much flick it. You can also get him trapped, probably. So I do apologize, my recording messed up, but basically when you're killing these things, there is actually a safe spot, so I'll just attack a guard to show you. Because I've already killed him, but you can safe spot it just like this right here. So you attack it, and then once your bolt fires, you run back just like so, and that's going to be the easiest way to basically get Keef down. Now once Keef is at very low HP, he's gonna basically say, no, stop killing me, I regret what I've done, don't do that. And then once you're done with that, we can go ahead and teleport to Trollheim just like so. And once you have teleported to Trollheim, what we need to do is... Oops, that was Taverly, not Trollheim. So we teleport to Trollheim, not Taverly, like my mess up there. And then what we need to do is go ahead and climb down the closest rocks here. And then let's just move down here and go a little bit to the south. And there'll be another rock thing coming up here that we can climb down. Right now we can just walk down it, and then we climb down this thing of rocks, and then we run just into this little area over here. And once we're inside this little area, we need to run north upside the passage, make the roundabout, and enter into the stronghold. Now go south. And And this will get us to the second boss. Simply go ahead and talk to Cobb. Once again, you say, you know, that he's, you know, his plan, which, and then you say option two, you fight him, whatnot, and then you can go ahead and run here and safe spot him, you kill him, and then once he gets down to a certain amount of HP, he's gonna say he regrets what he's done, and that he's no longer going to help the gnome, or sorry, the, monkeys, and then you will be ready to move on to the next portion. So once you're done with killing both of those, go ahead and make your way back to a bank. Alright, so gear-wise, I'm just bringing ranging gear. Of course, my monkey speak amulet, my two greegrees, my Kirk greegree, and my ninja greegree. I am bringing a lot of stamina potions. You're going to need a lot of these for these part. I'm also bringing a couple super restores, a couple ceridolin brews for food, a antidote plus plus, and I'm bringing two teleports to Apatol, and I am bringing a light source and one click teleport. Alright, so to begin, go ahead and teleport to Apatol. And then equip your greegree. It doesn't really matter which one. I'd recommend putting on the Kirk greegree. We're going to need that later anyways. And go ahead and just run back to the commander guy. I forget his name. Garcor, go ahead and speak to him. And he'll let us know the work. Or we'll tell him that the work's been done. Okay, so we now need to go find a guy called Lee Smith who is located somewhere here on Apatol. It's random for everybody. It could be in the same spot as me, if you guys are lucky. But there's three most common areas that it seems that he's on. So check them first. He can either be on top of the main gate, the third floor of the jail, or the third floor next to the rune stall. But basically, the one thing to keep in mind when you're looking for Lee Smith is he's not located on ground level. He's always going to be either up a ladder, up two ladders, or something else like that along those lines, but not on ground level. So I'm going to go ahead and try to find him, and then I'll be back. So a helpful hint is when you guys are up top, you can see him on other parts of the map, and you can also see yellow dots. So I went to a different building than the one he's on, but I was able to pick him out. Alright, go ahead and talk to Assistant Lee Smith. Say I was going to ask you the same question. Ask why is that. Say you have already been informed about the battleships. Ask where the fleet is currently. Now go ahead and report back to Garcor from wherever you are. Alright, so go ahead and speak to Garcor. Alright, so now we need to go to the airships. This is located up around here. Follow where I go on screen. Make sure that you have your Kirk Monkey Greegree on. Alright, so here we are with the monkey guard. This is where you need to be. So it's this location on the map. And go ahead and talk to the monkey guard. And ask what's going on here. Ask about the construction platform. Ask if you can visit. And he will take you here. Alright, so basically the goal here is we need to follow a certain route to get to the satchels first, and just avoid the monkeys while you're doing it. They can only see directly ahead of them from their eyes. They can't see to the left or right. So go ahead and follow the route that I now show on screen. So this was the first ladder that I'm talking about, but the ladder that we need to get to is actually over here. So we just need to keep following the path over this way. But if you do want to take a break, this is a safe spot. Okay, sorry, this ladder was the one at the dead end that I was talking about, but nevertheless, this is where we had to go. So once you're at this point, you need to go ahead and go south. And we will get to a ladder here, which we can climb down. Go ahead and climb down that. All right, now we can go ahead and follow this path until we get to the end here. There's no monkeys on this path, and at the end are the satchels. Go ahead and search the crates. Make sure you get yourself 6 of these. All right, so make sure that you do have 6 satchels. And now remember that first ladder that we got to. The very first ladder that you run into, we need to go ahead and get back there somehow. You can either get caught by the monkeys because you won't lose these satchels when you get caught. Or you can just go ahead and run back there. I'm going to get caught and show you the way back. I'm now going to show you guys the route to the explosives from the start point. So go ahead and climb up this ladder. Make your way to this ladder. Climb down it. And now we will be at the barrel, which we can get the explosives from for the satchels. Just go ahead and wait for all six of them to be filled up. Now, if you investigate it, it will see that they're all primed. Awesome. Okay, so now this first route that I'm going to show you is going to take you to the first place that we're going to put down a satchel. Keep in mind that once it's put down, if a monkey catches you, they won't actually take it away anymore. The thing that you put down won't actually go away, so you won't need to do it again. However, you will need to fill up your remaining satchels with gunpowder again. Alright, so here's the first spot. Go ahead and use the satchel on the compromised floorboards. Let's go ahead and continue on to the next area now. climb up this ladder. And once you get here, go ahead and use a satchel on it. Now, I forgot to fill them, but this is where you need to be. Okay, I'm going to recommend that you guys go ahead and just get caught, because there's one really close to the explosive barrel and one really close to the bottom floor that you might as well get out of the way now. Alright, so this is the ladder that you go down to get to the explosive barrels. As you can see here, I can go down and then the explosive barrels are over there. So anyways, go ahead and come to that ladder here, and then just a little bit to the south of it, there will be a compromised floorboard. Go ahead and use a satchel on that. Alright, so now the next one here is this compromised support. The start point is over here if you look on the map, and then you just run around and then you come up here and you're here. I'm sure you guys have been to this area or at least passed it 100 times getting to the refill barrels and whatnot, but there is a beam here. Just go ahead and use a satchel on that. Hopefully that location is clear for you guys. And now there's two more to go. So this is the next location. It's located on the bottom floor because it's a compromised support. And okay, so it's located, you see this little ladder that I'm hovering my mouse over right now? That's the first ladder that you take when you're getting to the barrel of explosives. So you go to that ladder and then you just run down a little bit south and take this little east point in here and go ahead and use your satchel. Oops, you use your satchel on the compromised support, but I already have. And then it will be good to go. We're going to make our way now to the very last one of these. So I'm just going to show you where to go from here. And then you just climb up this second ladder here. And it's going to be on the western side. And this is the last one. Use your satchel on it quick. And that is the very last one. Awesome. So once you have charged them all up, you can go ahead and just get caught by a monkey here to be sent back to the start. Only took about 3 hours. All right, now just go ahead and climb down the ladder. You'll board the boat and you'll get a message saying you narrowly escaped the explosion as you row away from the platform. Go ahead, check your quest log right now because you don't want to mess this up. That it says you should report back to Garcor. Now, if you have that message, go ahead and put on the Kirk Monkey Greegree again, and let's go ahead and report back to Garcor. Now, it doesn't drop you off where you got in, so you can just go ahead and run in these doors here of Apatol, which are just to the north. Go ahead and talk to Garcor. Alright, so let's go ahead now and head to that dungeon, which was up all the way northwest. Alright, so there's that hangar and that icon anyways, and then down from it right here is the little jungle trapdoor. Go ahead and enter in that thing, and now this time we're actually just going to be running north. Now once you get up here, you can put on your Kirk Greegree and then you can swing across the monkey bars. It's pretty cool. Then head north and enter into this passage. Go ahead and walk over here, open up the door, and you see this. Go ahead and climb on it, the demonic gorilla, and then climb down the stairs. Now these guys shouldn't hit you too hard, but we need to kill both of these torture gorillas. If they do, you could always prayer flick, I suppose, if you start dying. But it's really the gorillas doing the fighting and not your gear. However, your health is the one at stake. Let's keep that in mind. But you should really be fine. So go ahead and attack all three of these until they go back in the cage. So if you're trying to prayer flick, they hit right at the start of their attack. So like when their claws move up is when the hit actually happens. And prayer seems to work against these guys. I know earlier bosses it didn't. And that's the last one. A cutscene will occur. Then go ahead and use the holding area over here. And now let's go ahead. There's some boxes just to the south in this room, or crates. We need to search these crates until we get a chisel and hammer. We're going to get a whole assortment of poop, but just go ahead and get a chisel and hammer from these crates. All right, it may take a little bit to get them. Just go ahead and try different boxes in the room. It's basically random what items you'll get, but eventually you will get the hammer and you will get the chisel. Now go ahead and climb up these staircases and head north. You'll see a device. Go ahead and tamper with it. You need to be in human form. You're going to get a charged onyx. Go ahead and use your chisel on it, which will get you a deconstructed onyx. Use that on the device. And let's go ahead now and investigate one of these incubation chambers and make sure that it says it has been successfully corrupted. Now we need to go and head back to Garkor. Once you're back here, speak to Garkor. Make sure that you have your Kirk, Monkey, Greegree equipped. And then once you're done speaking to him, speak to an Elder Guard to pass through. Talk to King Awowogei. You'll run through the options with him. Now go ahead and talk to the Elder Guard to leave again. And talk to Garkor. And a cutscene will occur. And those are some airships. A looming shadow. Now go ahead and read your quest dialogue. We need to go make sure it says basically something about going to the king in the gnome stronghold, and go ahead and get yourself to the king in the gnome stronghold. Go ahead and talk to King Narnode, and that puts us on chapter 5. We are on the very last home stretch of this quest. Let's go ahead and go to a bank and go gear up now. All right, so here's what my setup is. It's gear. I have a range switch and then my melee, and basically I'm only bringing gear that I don't mind if I lose. So I'm really only going to be risking my D-boots and like a glory and like a crystal bow. So it's not really too bad of a risk, maybe a bit of mil. So yeah. Inventory wise, I'm rocking 6 super restores, 12 Ceridoman brews, 1 prayer potion, 2 antidote plus pluses, 4 bits of food here, and a 1-click teleport. Okay, so now we need to go ahead here and climb down the staircase and head to Neve. Sorry, you might have not been in that staircase, but go ahead and make your way to Neve and talk about Monkey Madness 2. Say yes to recruiting Neve. And she's going to basically start running north, and she's going to start targeting creatures for us to kill. There'll be a red arrow, and then they'll turn to a yellow arrow, and we need to kill these until she says that's enough. You can pray melee while doing this, and it should block their hits. I believe you need to kill 4 of these things. I'm just going to skip ahead until they're all done. And basically, you always just want to make your way north or run around until you find them. For me, it seems to always be just go north. And once you've killed enough, she'll speak to you and ask you to join the 10th whatever. And just say okay to that. And make sure that you do say okay to it. Alright, and now we need to run north here in the Gome Stronghold up to this little bridge that my cursor was hovering over. Now at this point, if you did kind of run low on food or supplies, you can bank because we're coming up on something. So yeah, you can bank if you did run low on food or supplies. All right, so go ahead and talk to Garkor here and say yes. Now we're getting into the boss fight now, but there's 2 portions of it. And after the first portion, you can then bank and then finally kill Gla, or however you pronounce that guy's name. Now there's going to be some monsters attacking you here, not really a big deal, but go ahead, keep moving forward until you get to the dungeon entrance, and then go ahead and enter in the cave. Now you're just going to follow this cave, make sure that everything is restored up for you guys, and then keep running north in this cave. Now there's some monsters in here, and it's worth to note the type of prayer that you should be praying. So if you see these like green balls being shot at you, they're magic attacks, protect from magic. If they're white balls, they're ranged, protect from range. And of course, they can also hit with melee too. Now, also, they're going to be throwing big boulders. They're literally just big rocks flying through the air. If that happens, it's a range attack, and make sure that you move away from it. That way it doesn't land on you, because if it does land on you, they do a tremendous amount of damage. Now, if you guys lose Neve, simply relog and she'll be out front of the Grand Tree. And this can happen if you guys basically either die or teleport out. All right, and he is killed. And Neve rushes in like a dummy, and bye bye, Neve. Never be found again. And you'll get some ashes. And now if you guys need to bank, you can go ahead and do that. You're completely fine to, and you can come back and do the final boss. I'm gonna go bank. That actually sadly took me like 3 attempts to be able to kill that first one. All right, so I've re-geared up now. This is my gear. I'll make sure once again that I'm not losing my DFS. And all right, everything looks good. So let's run into the next room here. I'm pretty sure we protect from melee and protect item, of course. And he'll be in here. Go ahead and attack him. And then just run back to this front entrance. We'll be able to actually safe spot him from here. Just like so, he can't come any further. And then you can just sit here and sit back until you manage to kill him. Well, sorry, my bad. You'll get him down to like 1/3 HP, and then he'll run off, and then we'll do another method. So I'll be back once he starts to run off. All right, and when he starts to run away, you'll see he pushes this boulder out of the way. And it runs into this room here, and we need to chase him. Turn on protect from missiles when you're in this room. He's going to stomp the ground and do some stuff like that, which hurts. All right, so you see that? But we can safe spot him still. So anyways, I'll be back once I've killed this part. So like, yeah, he'll get down to like half HP in this room, and then there'll be one more room after this, and then that will be pretty much quest complete. Alright, and then once you hit him down to about half HP, he's going to run to the last room. Now in this room, he'll throw you back, and you want to protect from melee. And that is the final boss complete. To do a bit of a safe spot there, he kind of still hits you, but that's kind of nice to do. I was really struggling with that boss, and my power cut out last night when I almost killed it. So I'm really recording this now, hours later. Oops. Alright, anyway, so you're going to be teleported out of this crash site. Go ahead and talk to Carador. He's going to tell you to report back to the king, then talk to Zunok and say yes, and he'll give you a free teleport back. That's pretty cool. Go ahead and talk to the king. And there'll be a chat here. And then the monkey king will come. And Monkey Madness 2, Part 2, will be complete. Now, you can actually get some more XP. You'll also get this Royal Seed Pod. Now, there was Seed Pods before, but they were consumable. This one, I believe, is infinite use. Now, if you guys want additional EXP from this quest, I believe it gives you around 100k. Go to Apatol, then you see this area here, come up here. There's a ladder you can climb. You go over the bridge, and then you climb down. And you speak to Duke, and he will let you choose two skills to get 50k in each. I'm going to go with magic. 50k XP. He's going to do some teaching. Not sure if this gives defense or anything like the old one. So maybe be mind to that, but didn't look like it. And then let's get some more magic here. That should bring me to 70. Alright guys, and that is it. Quest complete and you've unlocked everything. You've got an XP after it. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time, love, peace, and chicken grease.